أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وبه يستعين في جميع الأمور الحمد لله الذي يبسط الرزق لمن يشاء ويقدرها وخير الرازقين وصلى الله على نبيه محمد وآله الطاهرين ودعاتهم المتقين مؤمنين مؤمنات Those who seek an honest living, halal ni rozi. Salaam alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May you be among the people for whom Allah has perfected His blessings, both the manifest and the concealed among them. May Allah Ta'ala shower you with His barakat and open wide the doors of your livelihood. In today's majlis, I will do this bayan. How do you earn a good living? I will discuss this question and some of the bayans in our kitabs relating to it. What actions and deeds increase your livelihood? And what should your intention be in earning a livelihood by which you multiply your provisions for the hereafter in this world, which is the true purpose of life on earth? I will do this bayan with Allah Ta'ala's aid and with the barakat of His Wali Imam Zabaan. Ta'eed, inspiration. Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna Allaha huwa ar-razzaqu zul quwwati al-matin. Allah is the provider of sustenance, the possessor of strength. There are many more ayats like this one asserting that Allah is the one who provides livelihood and sustenance. The first thing you must do is to believe that Allah is the sustainer. Come to this conviction that Allah Ta'ala is the one who provides. When a mu'min seeks to make a living, he supplicates Allah for sustenance. Allah Subhanahu further says in the Quran, if Allah were to spread out sustenance for His servants, for the whole humans in the world, for all the humans in the world, they would practice treachery on each other. Instead, He sends down in due measure what He wills. Human beings need to expend efforts to earn a living. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, Upsud bisatak wastarzik rabbak. Spread out your wares, means open your shop, go to work, and ask God for sustenance. Always keep in mind that Allah is the one who provides. A man once asked Sadiq Imam to pray that he would get sustenance, food, sitting at home, doing nothing. Imam alayhi salam said, no, first you make your efforts. Feel the heat of the sun, work hard, then I will pray for you. When you seek your livelihood, do so with this conviction that Allah is the one who provides, and then make your full efforts. The report about Baqir Imam Salawatullahi Alayhi is well known. He personally would go to his fields. That is an important lesson that Mu'mineen should take to heart. Now, in earning a livelihood, keep your intentions noble. Work to earn money so you can live comfortably. Take care of your family, your children. Use it also to do good deeds, to serve Dawat, to strengthen Allah's religion, and you will increase your provisions more and more for the hereafter, which is the reason you have come into this world. Together with this, place all your trust in Allah, as I explained in the previous majlis. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that no one will die before he has received all the sustenance written for him. Rasulullah said further that if you place complete trust in God, He will sustain you as He sustains the birds. In the morning their stomachs are empty. By evening their stomachs are full. Rasulullah said yet further that making an honest living earns the reward of jihad. With this lofty intention and with trust in Allah, set out in the morning for your work. Also start your day early. Rasulullah has said, late risers earn no pay. Now I'll move on to the next point. In order to increase your earnings, to obtain barakat in your livelihood, what are the directions that our mawali have given us? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that integrity brings sustenance. Fraud brings poverty. Ameer Mumineen salawatullahi alayhi said, istanzilu rizqa bis sadaqa. Draw sustenance to yourself by giving alms to the poor. Ameer Mumineen further says that Allah increases the sustenance of those who give zakat. Also, following the teachings of our mawali, you should recite this litany, tasbih, 110 times. Allahu latifun bi'ibadihi, yarzuqu man yasha'u, huwa al-qawiyyul aziz. Allah Ta'ala is kind to His servants. He provides for whomever He wills. Our mawali has also instructed that whoever is finding difficulty in earning a livelihood should with all sincerity recite this tasbih 110 times. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. Whoever is conscious of God, God will find a way out for him and sustain him from a place he had not expected. Whoever has faith in God, God will take care of him. Sins and transgression also cause sustenance to be cut. Pray to Allah for forgiveness. Do tasbih astaghfirullah, which means I seek Allah's forgiveness 1,000 times. Astaghfirullah. And if Allah Ta'ala has granted you sustenance, then give others interest-free loans, karzan hasana, because of which Allah will increase your sustenance, your barakat, manifold, as He has promised in the Quran. Sadiq Imam alayhi salam has said that if you feed others, sustenance will rush towards you. That is one of the reasons why we place so much emphasis on feeding others. And the most important point to remember is this: always thank God for His blessings, for His sustenance. As Allah Ta'ala says, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you give thanks, I shall increase your blessings. And for the person who spends in Allah's cause, in khidmat of Dawat, Dawatul Haqq, Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran, this is the ayat in the Quran, I will translate, the examples of those who spend their wealth in the path of Allah is that of a grain of wheat, out of which grow 7 wheat cobs, and each cob is 100 grains. Allah multiplies for whom He wills. Allah is all expansive, all knowing. Wallahu yudha'ifu liman yasha. Wallahu wasi'un 'alim. Walana Burhanuddin Ridwanullah alayhi always used to say that we Dawoodi Bohra are a merchant community. Vepari qaum. There is profit in trade, barakat. But you must learn how to conduct business. If someone who does not know how to swim jumps into deep water, he will incur harm. It is important to obtain a good education in order to earn a living. You should also keep abreast of what is happening in the world, understand the workings of the economy, which country you live in, should know its monetary policies and the globalization phenomena we live in today. What is the demand for a particular commodity going to be in the future? One should have a grip on all these things. And also remember this directive, very important. My father, Maulana Qutbuddin, used to narrate from Syedna Taher Fakhruddin, when Babaji Sahib, Maulana Qutbuddin, was young, was traveling with Syedna Taher Fakhruddin by train one time, and he was getting ready to sleep. Syedna Qutbuddin took off his wristwatch and placed it near his pillow before sleeping. Maulana Taher Fakhruddin told him to keep it on his hand, for in haste to get off at the station, one could forget his watch in the train. Sayyidina Taher Fakhruddin then said an amazing line of counsel. Son, protect your property as you protect your life. Beta, maal ni jaan ni misal hifazat karvi jo hai. A further point I want to make is that it is important to have courage in earning a living, whether a business or a job. There is always risk in everything. There is risk in crossing a road. Taking risk is necessary, but it should be calculated. But if you never get up, never have the courage to do anything, then what will you achieve? Plan and strategize fully, then go forward with courage and place your trust in Allah. God is the sustainer. And it is also important for you to understand your own nature and personality. How much capacity do you have for tolerating that risk? Some people take on so much debt that they cannot bear its weight. In taking any action, you should proceed with mature thought and deliberation. Sometimes in life, one may have a setback. In those situations, do not lose heart. Remember, Allah has countless blessings, and give thanks and you will obtain courage. Get up and keep going. Amir Mumineen has said, lost asset that teaches you a lesson is not lost. Ma zahaba min malika ma wa'azaka. Never give up. A man asked Rasulullah that the business that I am engaged in has no profit, no barakat. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, have you made profits in another business in the past? He said, yes, I had a good income from this earlier particular business. Rasulullah said to him, do the business that was profitable for you. And he did so and achieved barakah. Much bayan may be done on this topic, but it is necessary to keep it short. You have already heard Baqir Imam would himself go out into the fields. Sayyidina Ismail Badruddin Idwanullah Alayhi in Jamnagar had a large business and he served many da'is with his wealth. His intentions were most noble and high. He used to say that I have served the da'is tirelessly. Hands of gold and silver would be chafed with such service. Mamluk Ali Muhammad also have achieved expertise in business with Maulana Burhanuddin's permission and prayers and with my revered father Maulana Qutbuddin's training and blessing. Allah has showered many favors upon me and I give thanks to him always. فَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثِ. I used to say to Sayyidina Qutbuddin that my intention in this endeavor is to serve Dawat, which is what Sayyidina Qutbuddin himself taught me. Mumineen, keep your intentions noble and you will certainly gain success. Mumineen, Muminat, engage in honest commerce, halal no wepar, and you will receive good sustenance. If you follow the directions of our Mawali, you will receive barakat in your livelihood. And always take the wasila of Allah's awliya and supplicate Allah Ta'ala. Sayyidina Hatim's miracle is well known. A mumin took his wasila and a handful of earth from his grave and it turned into gold, dinars. I have spoken today of how to earn sustenance for your worldly life. Together with this, always seek to earn the sustenance of Dawat knowledge, which is even better than wealth. As Amin Mumineen Salawatullah Alayhi has said, knowledge is better than wealth. You have heard that bayan in a recent majlis. Today, people weigh success in the world through money, through how much wealth you possess, how much net worth one has, not by their self-worth. The intelligent person is the one who weighs success through how he spends that wealth. Maulana Taher Saifuddin used to say that, Je kharchate apna, meaning what you spend becomes yours. Otherwise, money is just pieces of paper. And Maulana Taher Saifuddin also used to say that you should divide your wealth into three parts. One part on living expenses, another part in Allah's cause, and the third part you should save and invest. Finally, what is the greatest sustenance? Rosie, most important risk. I will end today with that bayan. Maulana Qutbuddin used to say that the people of Yemen pray in this manner, which is very beautiful. They say, Allahumma rizukna ridaak. Allah, grant us the sustenance, risk of your being pleased with us, you being happy with us. Obtain the acceptance and pleasure of Allah and His Wali, which is a form of sustenance, loftier than all other forms of sustenance. Because of it, you will obtain the greatest success, paradise. Fawz-e Azim, Jannat-e Naeem. By the sanctity, hurmat of Muhammad, Ali Muhammad, and their du'at. May Allah Ta'ala open the doors of sustenance for all mu'mineen and mu'minat. May Allah grant you barakat in your children, your wealth, your business, your job, your sustenance. Always give thanks to Allah for His blessings, and they will increase for you day after day, inshaAllah Ta'ala. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. والصلاة والسلام على رسوله سيدنا محمد وآله الطاهرين وسلم تسليما متصلا إلى يوم الدين
يا صباح الخميس أهلا وسهلا زادك الله